let's catch this bug. So when we run the program, you can see down here that with 100 degrees Fahrenheit, it gives it 0 degrees Celsius. And we're expecting, if we look at our chart, we're expecting 37.77. So I'm going to set a breakpoint right here. Now right mouse click, toggle breakpoint. And then I'm going to click on the bug up on the control panel. And that's going to put me in debug mode. So I'm going to step into, well, I don't have to worry about set scale, so I can step over that. And then I'm going to step into show temp. So I'm going to check my scale, and it's C like we expected. So we think it's going to go down to here. So let's see if the program goes down to there. We'll step over. And sure enough, it went down to the C. And now it's going to print this out, and I want to get into this convert to Celsius. So I'm going to step into again. Now, this went into my float class, which is deeper than I want to go. So I'm going to step out of. And then step into again. Again. You see the way the code is written as part of the printf, it's hard to get into that convert to Celsius. So I'm going to go into thermometer. I'm going to go to convert to Celsius. So over here we'll go to convert to Celsius. And I'll put a breakpoint right here. Now, the way this code is written, this is going to be hard to debug too, because I won't be able to see what is being returned. So I'm going to rewrite this code so it's a little easier to debug. So let me stop my debugging. Go back into my Java. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up a float called Celsius. And I'll save the response into Celsius so I can view it. And then I'll return Celsius. So you can see I added a few steps, but it gives me the information I need so I can put a breakpoint there. So I'll put a breakpoint right on this line. You can see my breakpoint. I'll save my file. Oh, forgot a semicolon. And then I'll debug again. And I don't need this breakpoint anymore, so I'm going to right mouse click, toggle breakpoint, and then tell it to run. And here I am in my Celsius. So I look at my degree, and it is 100, so that's my Fahrenheit degree. I'll step over, and now I can see my Celsius is 0. Well, the first thing I'm thinking is maybe this formula is running wrong, so I'm going to separate this out, and I'm going to do this first, then I'm going to divide 5 by 9, and then I'll multiply the two together. So let's stop the program. Debug again. Program stops right here, so I step once. And do you see how changing my breakpoints allowed me to work with this much quicker and just focus in on that one little piece? I'll step over. Now look at my Celsius. It's still 0. Then it dawns on me this is a float. And what's 5 divided by 9? If I don't tell it a float, it comes out an integer. So it's 0 times degrees. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put 90F there. And let's see if that fixes things. I'll stop my program. Run debug. step over, look at Celsius, and there's my answer, 37.7778. So now I fixed my conversion routine and my program should run. So I'll let her go. And I'll double check my output, and you can see now that I have my 100 and it rounded it up to the second decimal point.